Connection. We're live. Happy Sushi Friday, everybody.
Welcome to Sushi Friday.
And we're not in our office.
We're not in our office again.
Surprise!
On location.
And we're not eating sushi. Is it backwards day? What?
It might be. It might be.
So we are here at the Harbor Ballet Theater this week with John Worrell. Thank you so much for being our special guest.
It's my pleasure.
And awesome. We just came off of Halloween. Mm-hmm. Did everybody have a nice Halloween?
Oh, yeah. Sure did.
Crazy? Super fun.
The weather was great?
It was great. I saw lots of great costumes. I saw lots of shaving cream.
I did.
I saw a few clowns that were a little creepy. But we survived the clowns.
Really good seats. Yeah. And lots of candy. More candy than my household should have.
Absolutely. Any household should have.
What's your favorite candy?
Well, I'm personally 100 grand. You don't see a lot of them.
It's
hard to come by. Not a lot to get home.
That might be my favorite, but I forgot about it because I have the Butterfinger.
Butterfinger's good. I don't get a lot of those because those are Bridget's favorites. Oh. She's a good sharer.
I stole some from my kids. We have some.
When they watch this again, they're going to be mad at you.
Yeah, I hit some of these neighborhoods too that give out the big king size bars. Yeah.
Okay, if I had to pick, I'd go for a good old, I just saw it, like a Hershey's. Plain old chocolate.
Really?
I like the good old plain old.
There you go.
Nice. That's actually
chocolate. Well, we've got plenty of dessert today.
Dessert before lunch? that's my second favorite.
Speaking of lunch, it was so delicious last week, and we decided that it's going to be our month of November at Locals in Port Jefferson. This is a classic favorite is the avocado toast.
Which is great. We got a couple weeks to try everything.
And that was your suggestion. Somebody commented, said we should try Locals.
Yep.
So keep the comments coming in.
Yep.
Please go have our lunch. And
if you have candy like this hanging around.
Yes, I'm sure we all have extra candy we don't need hanging around the house. So we can donate that to
Cool Smiles. Port Jefferson, the orthodontist. Mm-hmm. They're taking it all month long, right?
And they're actually giving you $1 per pound of candy that you bring in with a $5 maximum, which is way going above and beyond. I think we're happy just to get rid of it.
Yeah, but we don't necessarily need the dollar a pound, but
they will give you a dollar for every pound, and then they will donate it to Operation Gratitude, and that's going on between November 1st through 10th.
Yes. So your kids will have teeth without cavities, and people will be happy.
It's a win-win.
Yep.
Win.
Everybody wins. Everybody wins. It's awesome. It's good stuff.
So that is bringing us into November. How's your beard doing, Mike?
My beard's doing well. I actually saw a couple of my buddies this morning who are doing the No Shave November with me, and it looked like they cheated. They got a pretty good head start. You're supposed to be clean shaven November 1. John, I see some.
Just a little bit. I don't go much here, so I had to take it off because it doesn't look.
So, well, I think you can wear it very well.
Through the first when the show comes up.
Nice.
Just keep in mind why we're doing it. Men's health awareness and get your prostate
checked out.
Get checked. All right.
That's great.
Moving on.
Well, John doesn't necessarily know exactly why we were here today, other than we're going to talk a little bit about the Harbor Ballet Theater, but we're kicking off November being Gratitude Month. And I think that there are so many ways that, or so many things that go on that just happen on a daily basis, and it's so easy for us to get busy and not necessarily recognize all the things that people do every day that makes this such a great place to live. But I know one of the things that I really enjoy about being in this community is having the opportunity to go to the Nutcracker. And when my kids were little and we moved here, before they were born, and I saw that the Nutcracker was going on and brought them for the first time. It was just such a wonderful feeling to get back from that you get when you're a kid and just that kickoff to the holidays. And I know a lot of people that make that the start of their holiday season. They bring their grandparents or bring their family, meet, have a a brunch at downtown and then come and enjoy that. And it's so nice to kind of get away now. I mean, sometimes the holidays are a little stressful, or, you know, there's just so much going on with the cooking and the shopping and the lists and the doing that, you know, it kind of, in more ways than one, brings you back a little bit. It's a nice quiet time, and I know it's a lot to put on such a big production like that, and I don't think a lot of people realize how involved it is. So we're here to say thank you.
Yeah, because we're so grateful.
Well, you're welcome. It's our pleasure. It's been great. We started it back 26 years. This is our 26th anniversary. The way it came about is Harbor Ballet is a completely different company than the dance school, the Amy Tyler School of Dance. It's a 501c3, not-for-profit company. Amy and I used to be involved with a group called the Brookhaven Dance Guild.
Okay. Does that still exist?
No, because it was before the competition circuit really started out.
Okay.
And what it was a summer program where pretty much every dance studio on the island would all get together, and they bring in master teachers, jazz teachers, ballet teachers, and they do choreography workshops and stuff like that. And it slowly died away because the competition circuit kind of took over. But ballet and competitions aren't really synonymous with each other. You don't get the quality you want. So we wanted to come up with a way so the kids from any dance school on the island could be a part of it. So we said, all right,
we'll
And you knew from the beginning that you were going to put on a full-length ballet production. Was that the idea behind it?
Yep. It was, our goal was, not only do we do Nutcracker, we've also done Sleeping Beauty, Peter and the Wolf, and we also used to tour them into the schools.
Wow.
So, but the summer ballets were just not pulling enough people to support it.
Mm-hmm.
So,
it's tough.
Yeah, it gets very tough in the summer. Plus, everybody goes on vacation, so trying to keep your core without it being a paid group, it's very hard to keep your core dancers.
Sure.
Say, no, you've got to be here all summer.
But you do bring in professional dancers for the main roles for the Nutcracker. Right?
Oh, absolutely.
So, who are the professional dancers this year?
This year we have Jamie Coppett. She is a core dancer from American Ballet Theater.
Wow. And, so you don't have to go into New York City to get American Ballet Theater right here in Portland.
No, and we got her because Craig Saltzstein, soloist.
That's the Cavalier.
He was gonna be our Cavalier.
Okay.
Fortunately for him, he is now doing Carousel on Broadway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Good for
he's taking a year off from ABT. But he got us Jamie, and then through Craig and Jamie, we got, his name is Tanner Schwartz. He's worked with a lot of companies, Boston Ballet, so they'll come in and be our Sugar Plum and Cavalier this year.
That's great. Well, you put on such a high quality production.
You've been
doing it for how many years?
26.
26 years right here at the high school always?
We started at, our first year was at Center Reach High School. Our second year, which we don't talk about, was at Newfield High. Well, the problem is, it's a full scale show. So that means all of our every scene has its own set of scenery. Each act, or each part of the show. And then at Newfield High School, our second year, didn't have fly space, so I had to rig up.
What's fly space?
Fly space is what makes the drops go up and down.
Oh, okay.
So you have to have twice the height of where whatever your scenery is.
How many backdrops do you have for the Nutcracker?
We have four main backdrops.
Wow.
But each one of them carries legs and borders as well.
Wow.
Plus, and then, actually, no, I think of like six main drops, because we have the Drosselmeyer scene, and then the crossover scene, and then snow, and...
Makes for magic.
There's a lot more to it than just a few people dancing on stage, isn't it?
As an example, our fastest scene change, going from the Drosselmeyer scene in the very, very beginning, in his workshop, into the crossover scene, there's a 30-second change.
Wow.
And we have to move staircases and fly out drops and get everybody set and ready to go for the next section by the time they get in. So,
wow, that's great.
It's cool.
So, so you've been compiling over these years scenery, sets, costumes,
yep.
And every year the kids audition and then they're put into a role and they reuse the costumes from, so you have to alter them to fit each child or adult.
One of the things we look at in the audition process is, unfortunately, for if you have a young child who is very tall for their age, that is harder on them because it now puts them into, because we've built the costumes over the last 25 years, that puts them into a certain category. Mm-hmm. Okay, you're too tall to be an Angel or Paul Chanel, but you're really not ready to be in the party scene yet, or a
mask. Because of the skills because that are involved.
Right,
because
as you go up, the dances get more and more difficult. So that's an unfortunate part for it. I mean, we'd love to be able to take and buy new costumes for everything, but just as in the scenery has took us 22 years to finally get everything completed.
Wow.
So we just kept adding and
preserving it from year to year.
And you
that's
have
fantastic.
Also some members from the community that volunteer every year to be a part of it as well.
Oh, right? Absolutely.
Like Drosselmeyer, that's one of my kids' favorite roles because it's got the magic that happens with his, he has a couple pyrotechnics.
No, a little something there. A little something. Ever come see it?
Definitely.
But yeah, we have Mr. Butera from the elementary school. He's been a personal friend of mine since I came out here in 1989. And then the thing that we ask for, we don't charge anything for the kids to be involved. We, of course, being a not-for-profit, we have to raise money as donations, so we do ask if they can to donate. But what we ask the parents is for the parents to be involved, because there's no greater gift than for your parent to be actually involved with what your child is doing. So,
I heard Beth might have played a role in some angel
costumes. My parents spent many a year.
Yep. Absolutely.
So I know all about it.
Mm-hmm. And some of the dads are graciously, what's the right word?
Show off
their dancing abilities as party dads. Like costumes, if you're looking at the mouse costumes and the Paul Chanel costumes of an amazing woman in our community, Janet Stafford.
Can I just pick one of these?
Oh, absolutely.
The head of the mouse.
These were made last year, and she remade all of the mouse costumes.
That's
pretty
heavy. Yeah. And the head.
So what's
is
that filled
amazing.
With? Like stuffing?
There's an actual fat suit.
I mean,
inside.
They're really beautiful.
Yeah. She does amazing work, and she's behind the scenes, and she gives so much of her time and effort, and she's just truly amazing at what she does.
Wow.
Is
that
the
statue?
And this goes along with these beautiful.
Yeah, that's one of the party moms.
Oh, wow.
Beautiful.
So that's underneath.
This is what's underneath.
That's great.
Amanda, I don't know.
Oh, it looks good, right?
Yeah. I've seen party moms.
I've seen Amanda in one of these outfits before. I have pictures to prove it.
So when did the kids start rehearsing? This is something someone might not know
We have an open audition the week after school starts. We try to let the parents get back and get into the school schedule and go, okay, here's what we've got to do today. And then the first week after that, we have an open audition for anybody, again, from anybody in the area. And then we cast the show, and then the following weekend, we start in on rehearsals.
Mm-hmm.
The kids will typically... The older kids are usually doing more than one part, so they'll typically have 2 to 3 hours rehearsal on the weekends,
right.
An hour on Saturday, maybe 2 hours on Sunday.
Yeah.
We also do a company class, which is, because we do get people from different studios, we want to make sure everybody's doing their arms the same way. And each different schools have different ways of doing different steps.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to make them all look like we come from the same place. So there's an hour and a half on Saturday mornings for them to come in and take a class. And it's actually really great. We have a woman doing, she moved to Port Jeff recently, and she's teaching our company classes for us this year, and she's actually also teaching at a university in Pennsylvania.
Oh, wow.
She was going to be on staff for us, but she got the job in Pennsylvania. So it's just another way to bring a higher caliber education to the kids. Yeah, absolutely.
And the arts, which is, you know, always a struggling for funding. Yeah, it's tough to keep up sometimes, but it's such an important part of of what we have here. So thank you again.
Oh, it's our pleasure.
Yeah, thank you.
Make sure everybody comes out and supports the Nutcracker.
Yeah,
how can you get tickets? For the first year, we're doing online ticket sales through
great.
A company called Eventbrite.
Oh,
so
yeah.
If you go to eventbrite.com, I know that a lot of people in the chamber uses them.
Yes.
They're a very secure site. So you can go onto harborballet.com, and up and in the right hand corner, there's a spot where it says Nutcracker tickets.
We'll put a link.
Okay.
Yep, put a link
and,
in the comments.
Or you can go to eventbrite.com and search Nutcracker and it'll pop right up.
We'll definitely make that easy for people to find. Mm-hmm. And then as part of this, we are going to continue to our month of gratitude and ask if you have anyone that you can think of. I'm sure everyone has a list mile long that, you know, we just want to share our thanks with everyone.
So feel free to post a comment of somebody that you know that gives back to others, gives back to the community. You know, that doesn't have to be, they don't have to go out and save people's lives every day just to make it, our community a better place to be. So feel free to give us their name and give them a shout out and we'll try and reach out.
And just remember too, you can post whether you're watching this live or post if you're watching a playback later on tonight. Just feel free to post anytime.
Absolutely.
Comment and like. Comment and like, and do it often.
Share
is caring.
So, we will also be posting on our blog a list of ways that we can get our kids involved with Gratitude Month and paying it forward. There's just some very simple things that that might think of to share with them, ideas, and we highlighted a couple of them. One that I really liked was if you shopping with the coupons and you're not you can't use that coupon, that you leave it right on the shelf next to that item. So the next person that goes to grab that says, oh, look at that, 50 cents off. You know, that's something that brightens somebody's day, just that little bit of something, you know.
Yep, it doesn't have to cost anything.
No, it doesn't have to be
day special.
And teach the kids hold the door open.
You could do something as simple as text someone. Just telling them how much you admire them.
Yeah,
a text.
I appreciate that.
I actually received one of those texts the other day.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Yeah. I get one.
And I wrote back, I said, what do I owe the honor? And I didn't get a response. It was just somebody that said, I appreciate you.
Sweet.
With a smile.
Aww.
What a nice
thing.
Awesome.
Yeah. And it makes
nice
you want to do it to somebody, right?
Still wondering what I did for them, but I'll figure it out.
Which leads it to pay it forward.
We are recognizing on November 13th, that day, all day, as a team, we're going to be paying it forward and doing some of those events in the community. And if you have any ideas that you want to share of ways to pay it forward, that will be November 13th. And if you want to participate with us on that day, you can also get a frame for your Facebook or Instagram, Pay It Forward frame, which we'll be sharing, and you can share all these great things, you know, just the goodness that's going on, and we can concentrate a little bit on the positive things that...
So if you see these cards floating around on November 13th, you'll know why we're paying it forward. And if you get one, take it and pay it forward.
Wonderful.
Simple as that.
Simple as that.
Yep.
Simple as that. And we'll have an extra hour to do that.
An extra hour. Oh my God.
Daylight savings time.
He's still my heart.
It's too dark. Wait, we'll have the time.
Everybody on Sunday, remember, fall back, right? Set your clocks back at 2 o'clock. It goes to 1 o'clock. You get an extra hour to sleep.
That's great.
But
we also have to remember to do what?
The more important thing.
Yes. Is?
Smoke alarms and carbon monoxide detectors. Time to check the batteries and make sure those are fresh. Could save your life, your family's life.
That's right.
All right?
Yeah, can't go wrong there. And there was one other little tip that we came across this week.
Absolutely. Last week, a lot of people lost power, which is
always a bummer. I was one of those days, no power, right here. No power.
And if you have a freezer full of food, no one's ever sure. Do you throw the food out, or
I wish I knew this last week.
Oh, that's a great tip.
So I saw a great tip online. What you do is you fill up a little cup of water in your freezer, and once it's frozen, put a quarter on the top of that cup. So after a power outage, you can open your freezer, and if the quarter sank to the bottom, that food is no good. And if the quarter is like midway through, then use your best judgment, and when in doubt, throw it out. That's my tip.
That's my tip. Yeah, that's
great. Like so easy. Everyone's got to cut them some water. So.
That's right.
Yeah.
Anything else anyone has
to
add on?
November 5th, okay. And something else to bring your attention to, the Metropolitan Youth Orchestra.
Ooh.
Encompassing both an orchestra and choir components. They do have events this weekend at the Stoller Center. So on Sunday, November 5th, from 2 to 4, you will see the Suffolk Concert, Symphony, and Principal Orchestras at the Stoller Center, made up of kids from all of Suffolk County. These kids are phenomenal. Go out and support them.
That sounds great.
Yeah, later in the evening, from 7 to 9 at the Stoller Center, it will be the choirs. So that's the Suffolk Treble Choir, Concert, and Symphonic Choirs at the Stoller Center. Tickets are no longer available online, but you can pick them up at the door.
Great. All right. Okay. Sounds like fun. Thanks, Mike.
Yeah.
Well, this food smells really good.
It is.
Yeah. Should we dig in?
We should. Oh. Have a wonderful weekend.
Olivia, my niece, she had her ankle repaired this morning. Feel better, sweetheart.
Feel better.
Aww. Feel better.
All right. Feel free to comment, share, and any thoughts on paying it forward or showing gratitude.
We'd love to hear it, and we'll be posting all week. See you next weekend.
Bye.
Bye.